Good evening, everyone. It's good to see you all. Let me call to order our Lynnwood City Council business meeting for today, Monday, May 23rd, 2016. And if I might call upon Councilmember Ross for the flag salute.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Council Assistant Moritz, could we have roll call, please?
I will. Mayor Smith?
I am here.
Council President Boyer?
Here.
Council Vice President Goodwin?
I, too, am here.
Councilmember Cotton?
Present.
Councilmember Ross?
Here.
Councilmember Sessions?
Here.
Councilmember Hurst?
Here.
Councilmember Sutton?
Here.
The council is present, Mayor.
Thank you. Moving on to item 30, the approval of our minutes. Council President, will you do the honors?
I would be happy to. I move that the council approve the minutes from the work session of May 2nd, 2016, the business meeting of May 9th, 2016, the special work session of May 11th, 2016, and the work session of May 16th, 2016.
Second.
Thank you. Any amendments, corrections, Councilmember Cotton?
Thank you, Your Honor. I just on so on item D, page 30.D.3, on line 59, where we were talking about the DADUs, the detached additional dwelling units. Line 59 says there was a consensus of the council to move forward, and I think there was. So, I'd like to maybe amend the language to say something like, however, several council members voiced concern regarding this item, because I felt like there was still ongoing. So I would just move to amend line 59 to say, however, several council members voiced concern regarding this item.
Do I have a second to that?
Second.
Any more discussion or amendments? All right. All those in favor of adopting the minutes with the one amendment on page 30-D.3, line 59, to say several council members
voiced
concern, please say aye.
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 Any opposition? Thank you. Just a couple of messages from me this evening. On May 11th, we hosted at the Convention Center a community open house, and it highlighted numerous city projects that are and initiatives that are underway in Lynnwood, and also the work of some of our valued community partners, such as Verdant Health was there, Edmond School District, the College, Community Transit, and Sound Transit. We had well over 100 residents and stakeholders attend, as well as numerous city employees who also learned a lot about their city that evening. But we had a wonderful time engaging, and it was a great event. You may have seen the news story or on our social media pages that on Friday, May 13th, we had a very special visitor to our fire station 15. If you could recall Brenda Walsh, she was the one who suffered a horrific attack in late 2014, was left dead inside a burning home. And she came to the station and visited and thanked the men and women who saved her life that evening. And it was indeed the fire paramedics that saved her life. So it was a very rare thing that happened, that it was a full circle, that the person that they saved and she lived got to come back around and meet them face to face. And so we wanted to give a special recognition to firefighter Scott Russell, Fire District 1 firefighter Melissa Beard, paramedics Josh Peterson and Kevin Miller, captains John Putz and Jason Turner, and to our Lynnwood Police Detective Brian Jorgensen. So not only did they help save her life, but they also testified at two trials, which resulted in her ex-husband being convicted of attempted murder and arson. And what these women did was remarkable, and it was a really great gathering. Last Monday, we hosted our internal budget kickoff with our department directors, deputies, and key budgeting staff. This will be our first budget experience using budgeting for outcomes. And City Administrator Art Sinise and I will be meeting with the departments regularly throughout this process to ensure that we're presenting a budget that aligns with our community vision and our council priorities. So on Tuesday, September 6th, I'll present my proposed preliminary budget, and then the final preliminary budget will be presented to council on Monday, October 10th. And then this coming Monday, a week from today, Memorial Day, we have another fabulous event planned for our Memorial Day celebration, and hope to see you there. That starts at 11 o'clock at our Veterans Park. So with that, we move into item 50, which is our citizen comments and communications. So there was a sign-up list, and we do have several people on the list. I will call your name, and you'll come forward, state your name, your address, and then you'll be given 3 minutes to share with us what your ideas or issues or concerns are. So first on the list is Gary McCaig. So if you'd like to come forward, sir.
Thank you all, and good evening. My name is Gary McCaig. My address is 4429 179th Street, Southwest, Linwood, 98037. So good evening, and I want to thank you all for your attention, your time and attention tonight. And I also want to give just a general shout out to the city of Linwood in general, that you provide such a simple, easy, and I think effective way for citizens to get involved in the local government. So thank you both personally and for the city. And excuse me if I have to read this, because I'm not used to this and I get a little nervous and I can't remember like I used to. Okay, so I came here today to ask the city council to adopt a resolution. A resolution to take a public stand that corporations are not people as far as election spending is concerned, that money is not free speech, and also to support some limiting of campaign funding and reporting thereof. Now, the reason I'm asking the city council to do this is, well, not, you know, I'm a volunteer supporting Yes on 735. This is a ballot initiative. It's already on the November ballot to get big money out of elections. But I've come here today to ask for your support. We'll start off with this issue affects every single one of us. Every single one of us as a citizen, every single one of you as an elected official. One of the things that we see is that the effects of spending huge amounts of money on federal elections has had a trickle-down effect, and it keeps getting lower and lower. There have been several instances in the last 6 years where outside money has had a huge impact on local races, and we just need to go back to some of the attempts to raise the minimum wage for an example of how outside money has affected local wages. Perhaps you have not been hit yet, any of you, from a large amounts of outside money coming in, but the potential is there. So because of that, I want to remind you that you are not alone in your support of this, assuming that you do support it. There are 17 other municipalities in Washington State that have already taken a similar stand. There are 16 other states that have also passed, states that have passed legislation to support the issue. When it's been a ballot issue in Colorado, over 70%, 74% of the population supported it. In Montana, it was over 75%. So I think that this gives the Linwood City Council a chance to reflect the best interests of the city, of the citizens of Linwood, as it has in some of its other past resolutions and proclamations. So with that in mind, I ask you all to support it. This is to start the resolution, and I think I've done what I need to do to get it started. Oh, and by the way, if we're lucky, we won't have as many of those annoying ads.
Thank you, sir. Did you leave a copy of the resolution that you drafted?
I have left
you
have a it? Copy okay. With the clerk, yes.
Perfect. Thank you. All right. Are there others who would wish to speak tonight? All right. Let's move on to our presentations and proclamations. Our first proclamation is honoring Dr. Nick Brossett, the Edmonds School District Superintendent, for a bit longer, right? So, Council Member Vice President Goodwin, I see you're going to read the proclamation. Would you like to have Nick join you at the podium?
Certainly.
Okay.
Good evening. It's my pleasure to welcome Dr. Brossett and read a proclamation in his honor. Excuse me. Honoring Superintendent Nick J. Brossett. Whereas Superintendent Nick Brossett's career in education spans 32 years, all in the state of Washington. And whereas, prior to being named Superintendent of Edmonds School District in 2004, Dr. Brossett served in many advancing roles, such as superintendent of another school district, assistant superintendent, director of special programs, high school assistant principal, teacher, and coach. And whereas Dr. Brossett has worked extensively to bring together our ethnically and economically diverse community to ensure equality, equity, and equal learning opportunities for all students. And whereas Dr. Brossett has shown a tireless commitment for the sustained academic growth and success of all students of the Edmonds School District. And whereas Dr. Brossett's leadership resulted in the development of the district's strategic direction to guide the district's collective work for the next several years. And whereas Dr. Brossett successfully led multiple capital project campaigns to replace and refurbish school facilities in Linwood and district-wide, and worked in partnership with the city to repurpose surplus district properties and for the benefit of the Linwood community. And now, therefore, be it resolved that we, Mayor Nicholas Smith, the Linwood City Council, on behalf of the citizens, volunteers, and employees of the City of Linwood, wish to thank Superintendent Nick J. Brossett for his service and commitment to the students and families of the City of Linwood and our neighboring cities. And we encourage all residents to join us in extending our gratitude and appreciation for his service to our community. And I move that the City Council also agree with this resolution with me.
Second.
Thank you. All those who concur, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Thank you.
I'd also like to present you with a copy of the proclamation. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. You have any words to say?
Well, thank you so much. It's humbling and embarrassing, and but also appreciated. So thank you a great deal. And I guess as I think back over the 12 years, one of the things that we've had in common is a real desire to serve our communities, even though our responsibilities and our boundaries were sometimes overlapping and sometimes different, the work that was our work. But I think we define things that would help our communities as our collective work. And we just appreciate, on behalf of the district, just really appreciate your spirit of partnership, sometimes a spirit of adventure with some of the projects that we would take on. And I would have liked to have seen Linwood Place, you know, finished before I left, but it was easier to articulate than it has been to make it happen. So that'll still have to be finished later. But again, just really want to thank the city and thank you all for your service. And it's really an honor to be here this evening. So I appreciate that and wish you the best going forward. Thanks again.
Thank you. Dr. Brossett, do you want to come forward and have a group photo with us?
Just if you weren't embarrassed.
And if you don't, we want you to. Yeah, why don't you stand in front with him?
Yes.
Nice.
Come on, man.
Thank you.
Nick, thank you. You're leaving big shoes to fill.
Thank you.
We appreciate your stewardship. Thank you. So, do you see Kathy Coffey? Oh, that's not helpful. All right, we'll move on to our second proclamation and presentation. This is for Leadership Day, Snohomish County Leadership. Is Kathy Coffey here? Or is someone else doing a presentation? So no presentation? Proclamation. Let's start with the proclamation.
We'll
President Boyer.
Let's start at the very beginning. Very good place to start. I have here a proclamation of the City of Linwood for Leadership Day, October 14th, 2016. Is that right? October? Okay. We're way in advance
we
this
are,
time.
That's Kathy Coffey.
Whereas Leadership Snohomish County is recognized as the local organization specializing in developing leaders for a lifetime, making Snohomish County vibrant and providing education and opportunities for the past 18 years to strengthen our community. And whereas more than 100 employers in all sectors have participated in Leadership Snohomish County, and more than 500 Snohomish County professionals have graduated from Leadership Snohomish County. And whereas with 4 city employees that have participated and graduated from the program, the City of Linwood understands the benefits of Leadership Snohomish County to our city and county. And whereas Leadership Snohomish County intends to use Leadership Day to unite and recognize the role of leadership in our county and encourage community celebrations on this day as well. And whereas Leadership Snohomish County will undertake the recognition of the many contributions from our community leaders across Snohomish County as part of this day, as well as coordinate a leadership service opportunity. And whereas it is Leadership Snohomish County's intention to make Leadership Day an annual recognition of the importance of leadership, and now, therefore, be it resolved that we, Mayor Nicholas Smith and the Linwood City Council, hereby proclaim October 14th, 2016 as Leadership Day in the City of Linwood, Washington, and join in the recognition of the many contributions Leadership Snohomish County has made to our city and county. Signed, Nicholas Smith, Mayor, and myself, M. Christopher Boyer, City Council President, the city seal being affixed. And I would ask that council join me in voting concurrence in this proclamation.
Second.
And all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Well, I would like to take a moment for you to meet our leaders. So if I could ask Corbett Locke to come forward. He was been in the class of 2015-16. And is Will Cena here tonight? Will's, yeah. Oh, back there. Will Cena. Corbett Locke's our strategic planner with the city, and Will Cena is our information technology network management. Just come and get ready for the photo. And Amy Kirk, recreation coordinator, she was the class of 2014-15, and Julie Moore, manager of our communications and public affairs, was in the class of 2012-13. And can we add one more person to our family?
Yes.
Since he's here?
Yes, let's do it.
Shannon Tisdall, why don't you come forward?
Yes.
Shannon is the owner of Experience Momentum, and he was in this year's class as well. And not only with Leadership Snohomish, but he was also, along with our Sarah Olson, one of the top 12, and Shannon was actually one of the top 4 of the emerging leaders in Snohomish County. So, TV audience and members of City Council chambers tonight, these are our future leaders. Be proud. Councilmember Session.
Thank you. Thank you. Before the picture, I just wanted to add that this program takes quite a commitment off of these folks, and it's a big deal. It's an accomplishment, and not just anybody can do this and go through this process. And so congratulations to all of you. It's quite an accomplishment.
Here.
Good job.
Scooch in.
Scooch in. Okay. Thank you. I also want to thank the directors who are here tonight. Sonia Springer supported Corbett in doing his program, and Jim Kelly's in the back supported Will and Lynn Sardell last year supported Amy, and I don't know who supported you, Julie.
You.
Lynn did. Okay, I did. I think the mayor's office did, too.
You supported all of it.
Yeah, so good job, folks. All right, item 70, are there any written communications or petitions that I haven't gotten? We'll move on to council comments and announcements. And I would like to start with, who do I want to start with? Council member Cotton.
Yay. Muted celebration. I'll be taking up plenty of oxygen later, so under new business. But I did just want to say, it's with great gratitude that we had Dr. Brossett as our superintendent. I've always been impressed with what an amazing steward he has been of public lands and finances and the kids. So I just, if I'm going to say anything tonight, it would just be to say that we've been very fortunate to have his stewardship of all those things. So that's all.
Thank you. Councilmember Sutton.
Thank you very much. I just want to share with you that I just took a fast three-day trip to New Orleans. I had a granddaughter who graduated from Loyola Law School. And it was really quick and fast. And I'm still trying to get my feet down on the ground again, because when I looked at her and I thought, when she was just a little baby, how much I nurtured her and just wished the best for her. And now she's grown. She can make her own decisions. And it's just an amazing feeling, as some of you know, that when the individuals that you take care of or entrusted to take care of, and they become adults and start thinking around the fact how they can make an impact in their future leadership roles, it's just absolutely amazing. So I want to share that with you, as well as wish all the other graduates that have already graduated or will soon be graduating within the summer programs and et cetera. It's just been a really exciting time for us to look at what we're going to be bringing back to our city in terms of future leadership. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Councilmember Hurst.
Thank you. Last Thursday, I was able to attend a Snohomish County Cities meeting up in Stanwood, and the topic was drug issues and enforcement in Snohomish County. And it was, some of the information would blow you away as far as the heroin epidemic that's hitting Snohomish County. And the one fact that I came away with was that in Snohomish County, this county has the highest number of deaths due to heroin overdose. And that's not per capita. That's raw numbers. We have more than King County. We have more than Pierce County. And really, this epidemic is not just involving drug enforcement. It's a public health issue, and we really need to figure out how to address this. And I look forward to Human Services Commission addressing some of this, and really the city. A reminder. We won't have a business meeting before Memorial Day, so I would just remind you that take time to honor that day. It's a day to honor those who sacrificed, made the ultimate sacrifice for us, and so that we could have our freedom. And I just would like to remind you on that day. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilmember Sessions.
Thank you. So I want to remind you, if you haven't already heard, or let you know about some exciting things the city's doing coming up. The first thing are the disaster preparedness classes, four of them, that the fire department is facilitating for our residents. And there are four different ones, so it should work with your schedules, and you can pick which day to go. Invite your neighbors, and this is a good way to find out, you know, how to use ladders, how to turn off electricity out to your house and the different utilities to your house, and dealing with a variety of things you'd have to do directly after some sort of natural disaster. So please, if you're interested in that, contact Misty at the Linwood Fire Department. Also, Cops and Kids is coming up. I believe this is the third annual Cops and Kids. It's at from 10 to 12 on Saturday, June 4th at the Alderwood Mall. A lot of fun. You get to see all the different apparatus and canine officers and their handlers and SWAT equipment. It's a good time to get some positive fellowship with those police officers. So bring your kids, your family, and come on down to the mall for that. Finally, it's time to start signing up for National Night Out. National Night Out is an annual event that's been going on for years. It's based on crime prevention. It's when folks should turn their porch lights on, lock their doors, go out and meet their neighbors in the name of crime prevention. And in Linwood, for years, what we've been doing is we come to you. A lot of cities do it differently, but we find that that's the best way to do it so that you're actually meeting your neighbors and police, fire, different city leadership and public works and other departments in the city come by your neighborhood. It's as easy as putting together a small little coffee potluck to some people do full-blown barbecues and have events for the kids or whatever. You can do it as small or big as you like. And every year it just keeps getting bigger and more fun. And we touch, you know, more than 2,000 people in one night. It's quite a fun, exciting night. And that is the first Tuesday in August. Sign up as soon as you can with Lisa Wellington in the Linwood Police Department.
Thank you. Vice President Goodwin.
Thank you, Your Honor. I want to mention some things about what has been mentioned. Councilmember Hurst mentioned the awful statistics and news about the heroin epidemic in Snohomish County. One of the good things about Snohomish County is that we have a Snohomish County Health District, and that's one of the items on our list this year. I sit on the board, and there are a number of things that we're looking at trying to do what we can to help the epidemics. One of those would be teen suicides. That number has increased in Snohomish County over the last year or two, unfortunately, and same with the heroin epidemic. And so do know that there are bodies that are working on those terrible situations. And, you know, we're trying to work to do what we can to help alleviate and as much as we can eradicate those unfortunate events. Secondly, the Cops and the Kids, that is truly a fantastic event. I wasn't able to make it last year, but the year before I took my two oldest children down there, and they had a blast. They got to meet some of the police dogs and the big armored vehicles and all kinds of things, and it really is a good time. It's especially good when there's nice weather, and luckily that year we had that. So hope and wish for great weather this year so that the kids there can and adults can experience the same benefits. And lastly, the Memorial Day celebration that will be held on Monday is a fantastic event. I was able to make that last year as well with my family, and they all enjoyed it, except for the one that missed his nap. But aside from that, it was truly a great event, and you get to meet some fantastic people from the city of Linwood that have served and continue to serve the country and help us to enjoy the freedoms that we have. So if you have the opportunity, I'll unfortunately be out of town, but if you have the opportunity, I would strongly urge you to make that event and enjoy the companionship and fellowship there of those that have served for us. So thank you.
Thank you. Council President Boyer.
Thank you, Your Honor. First of all, I want to say I'm sorry that Nick Brossett got away before we could embarrass him any further. But two of my children graduated from Edmonds School District schools, and as we were in the process with those kids growing up through Edmonds School District, my wife Connie and I were so impressed with the leadership provided by Superintendent Brossett, and he's leaving some big shoes to fill. As I told him a moment ago, we're sorry to see him go, but well-deserved rest coming up for him, and I look forward to the new superintendent coming to talk to us in the fall. Also wanted to just briefly touch on Mr. McLard's request to us. He brings forward a very interesting situation. I had actually known that he was going to come and talk to us about that, and so I asked city attorney about the rules regarding that, because generally speaking, the law of the state of Washington prohibits public officials and employees from using public facilities directly or indirectly to assist any campaign for any person or promotion or opposition to a ballot proposition. However, there are some very specific rules that, if they are followed, can lead to exactly what Mr. McClark is asking for a city council to take a stand on an upcoming proposition. So, sir, I want you to know I'm taking your request seriously, but I also want to be very careful that this body adheres to the rules of the state. So we're going to be talking some more with city attorney about that, and we will walk through the process and make sure we do it comme il faut, as the French say. That's it for me.
Thank you. And Councilmember Ross.
Yes, I just wanted to remind anybody that's listening or out there that we are going to have a joint meeting with our boards and commissions on Wednesday, and I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be a really good event, and we're going to be able to get input from our volunteers who work so very hard for us, and I'm sure they have lots of things they want to talk to us about, so I'm looking forward to it. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, we'll move on to item 90, which is business items and other matters. 90.1, our unanimous consent agenda. And Councilmember Sutton, would you do the honors, please?
Thank you very much, Mayor. Would any council member like to remove any item from the consent agenda before I read it? No? Okay. Then I will continue. I move to adopt the following consent agenda items. Confirmation. Planning Commission applicant Shannon Tyslin. Confirm appointment of Shannon Tyson to position number 2 of the Planning Commission to fill the remaining term of a vacant position which expires December 31st, 2016. Item B, election of city representative to the Snohomish Emergency Radio System. The administration recommends that the council elect Acting Police Chief Brian Stanifer to be Linwood's new representative. To SERS, which stands for Snohomish Emergency Radio System. Item C, program agreement and grant agreement, Linwood City Senior Center and National Council on Aging. Authorize the mayor to sign Aging Mastery Program Agreement with National Council on Aging, outlining the program requirements. Number 2 of that is authorize the mayor to sign contract with the National Council on Aging to receive $12,000 in funding to implement the Aging Mastery Program. Item D, joint memo of understanding and resolution pertaining to Sound Transit's ST3 proposal. Adapt resolution 2016-08 and authorize the mayor to sign the MOU, which is memo of understanding. Item E, approval surplus of motorcycle. Authorize the mayor to surplus the 2011 Harley-Davidson FLHPI motorcycle, VIN number 1HD1FHM188864983. Wow, it's a mouthful. And number F, voucher approval, approved claims and payroll in the amount of $1,807,556.48 and $1,205,453.49, respectively.
Thank you.
That's the consent agenda.
If I might, let me read the VIN number again.
Yes.
So it's VIN
number. It's 1.
Yep.
H as in Harry, D as in David, 1, F as in Frank, H as in Harry, M as in Monroe, 18BB614983.
Perfect.
I think I said 80. Thank you.
Yes, thank you. All right, our consent agenda will be adopted as read. Well, tonight we have a public hearing. So let me get to that script. We are on 90.2A, public hearing of critical areas, ordinances, oh my word, ordinance updates. Right, no, I've just got it started. All right, so all persons wishing to be heard at this public hearing should have signed up on the sign-up sheet, but if you didn't, you will still be able to share. We'll give people 3 minutes to speak to the agenda item. The public hearing for critical areas ordinance updates is now open. This is a public hearing on a legislative action. Legislative actions include the adoption, amendment, or revision of comprehensive community or neighborhood plans or other land use planning documents, or adoption of zoning ordinances or amendments which are of area-wide significance. The purpose of this hearing is for City Council to hear testimony and take action relating to proposed updates to the critical areas ordinance. The public hearing must be fair and free of conflict of interest. Therefore, I'd like to ask, and this applies to myself as well, does anyone have a conflict of interest on this issue? This is our hearing procedure. Everyone will be given an opportunity to be heard. An official recording is being made of what is said at this hearing. Therefore, persons addressing the council are requested to begin by stating their name and address. Please speak slowly and clearly into the microphone. Only one person may speak at a time, and this is the time for the presentation of testimony. No debate is allowed. This is the order of speaking: a staff presentation to introduce the proposal. Secondly, testimony from the public, either in support of, neutral to, or against the proposal. I may deviate from the order if anyone has to leave early, so please let me know. Any testimony from staff in response to the testimony from the public. And fourth, City Council will then ask questions of anyone who has testified. So before hearing from our audience, I'm going to introduce Environmental and Surface Water Supervisor Jared Bond from our Public Works Department, who will make our staff presentation.
Thank you. The issue under discussion tonight includes updates to the city's critical areas regulations, which is Linwood Municipal Code Chapter 1710. The Washington State Growth Management Act, GMA, requires the city to update our regulations roughly every 10 years. Critical areas includes wetlands, streams, frequently flooded areas, fish and wildlife habitat areas, geologically hazardous areas, including landslide, erosion, and seismic hazards, and critical aquifer recharge areas. The proposed regulations endeavor to protect these areas using the best available science in accordance with the requirements of GMA. Some of the major updates include adopting Ecology's new wetland scoring form, allowing for more passive use of critical areas and their buffers, improved identification and protection of geologically hazardous areas, especially in light of some recent serious landslide events, incorporating measures to protect drinking water aquifers, particularly the artesian well along 164th, and including a variance process. Specifics of the changes were discussed at the work session last week, so I will just respect everyone's time by not going over those again. But, of course, I'm here to answer questions about the proposal, our process, or anything else you may have. The draft regulations under discussion tonight are the culmination of over a year and a half's worth of effort and public involvement. Targeted outreach efforts were made to key stakeholders, including the development community, the environmental community, state and federal agencies, and the general public. Throughout this process, there was no controversy or serious issues of concern raised about this proposal. Should the council wish to adopt these regulations this evening, the proposed ordinance is attached to this agenda item and not attached to the other agenda item under other business in order to save paper by eliminating duplication. That concludes my presentation. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Jared. Are there any written materials that have been submitted, or does anyone wish to submit anything in writing? So at this time, I will call upon the audience to testify and present any information, starting with those persons who have signed up on the sheet. The sheet is blank. Is there anyone in the audience who would like to speak to this? All right. Staff, nothing to respond to. Council members, it is your time to ask any questions of any speaker or the staff. Councilmember Sessions.
Thank you. We were able to discuss this and research this quite a bit before tonight, and I was happy to see that it was really a happy medium of both sides of this. It wasn't too extreme either way, and it really helps also to know that both sides, like the master builders, along with Pilchuck Audubon, other local developers, that everybody is really comfortable with it, which, you know, along with the things that you already researched and educated us with as well. And then also the few 7 comments that we received as well. Just tell me that this is a happy medium thing, and it's good. It's good improvements that need to happen, but not too extreme. So I am in favor of this tonight. Thank you. Not that I don't think it.
Any other comments or questions from council? Does anybody in the staff want to respond to Councilmember Sessions' comment?
This is Public Works Director Franz. Thank you. City has had this sensitive area code ordinance since 1992, I believe. We've modified it several times over the years. And so, therefore, it seems like each time we do modifications, it's more fine-tuning of the ordinance. And I think this time around, there's been a lot of more major changes made a decade or so ago. And this time around, it really was more fine-tuning, getting some of the things, that lessons learned over the last decade, but not substantial changes to land setbacks and things like that that really caused the kind of controversies that the previous changes has made. So yes, the changes were much less controversial this time.
All right, thank you. So there being no further testimony, I'll close the public testimony portion of the public hearing. It is now in order for the council to discuss matters and for a council member to make a motion to either take action, reopen this, or postpone the matter. Council President Boyer.
Thank you, Your Honor. Council Assistant, may I have a ordinance number, please?
3193.
3192?
Three.
I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. Too many years of loud rock and roll. Your Honor, I move the adoption of City of Linwood Ordinance Number 3193, an ordinance of the City Council of the City of Linwood, Washington, relating to the regulation of critical areas, amending Sections 17.10 of the Linwood Municipal Code, providing for severability, establishing an effective date, and providing for summary publication.
Second.
Thank you. Would you like to speak to the ordinance at all?
You know, I think we had a very comprehensive briefing in terms of the written materials submitted by the staff and their time with us at our last work session. As Director Franz has just said, this is really fine-tuning of existing legislation. Nothing major coming down the pike, just a few little additions. So I see no reason why we shouldn't move ahead with this.
Thank you. Any other comments? Yes, Council Vice President.
I just want to echo the comments that have been stated. We did discuss this quite thoroughly. Presentations from the staff was fantastic and updated us on everything. So,
all right.
I will be supporting this as well. Thank you.
Thank you. I'll call for a roll call vote, mm-hmm. please.
Councilmember Cotton?
Yes.
Council Vice President Goodwin?
Yes.
Councilmember Hurst?
Yes.
Councilmember Ross?
Yes.
Councilmember Sessions?
Yes.
Councilmember Sutton?
Yes.
Council President Boyer?
Aye.
7 yes.
Thank you. Ordinance number 3193 passes unanimously. We'll move on to 90.3B. This is the 2016 Comprehensive Plan Proposed Amendment. And Community Development Director Paul Krause and Gloria Riviera are here to speak to this.
Thank you, and we'll leave it up to the council as to whether or not you want us to walk through all the amendments. Tonight we have a proposed docket before you that has 11 amendments that have been submitted by private parties, property owners, or by the city. They were reviewed with a public hearing by the Planning Commission. The Planning Commission recommended that all 11 go forward through the comp plan process, and we had an opportunity to brief the City Council last week on them, and staff indicated we were comfortable with the Planning Commission's recommendation. What that all means is that, assuming the City Council approves the docket tonight, all 11 items will be worked on through the rest of the spring and summer. They will be subject to an environmental review. Staff would make a final recommendation to the Planning Commission. They would hold a public hearing. And that Planning Commission recommendation will come to you for final authorization approval in the fall. So tonight you're not being asked to say yay or nay to any specific item. It's just to move the docket forward. I do want to point out that we handed out tonight a corrected map. One of the docket items includes changing land around Edmonds Community College, most of which is occupied by the city golf course, to public facilities from park. That was requested by Edmonds Community College on the basis that, not that the golf course is going away anytime soon, but that the underlying property is owned by the state and could be an expansion of the college campus at some point in the future. Somebody on the council raised the question as to whether or not some of the golf course was actually owned in title by the city. We confirmed that they were right and that we are correcting the maps so that the land that's owned by the city would stay with the park designation while everything else owned by the state would go forward with the public facilities. With that, if you'd like us to walk through them all one by one, we can do that. Otherwise, we'll leave it up to you.
Would you like?
No need.
No need. Council Vice President Goodwin.
Yes, I move that we, the City Council of the City of Linwood, I just had a brain, so give me a moment.
All right.
Look under action.
All right, there. Yeah. That's. So I move that we, the City Council of the City of Linwood, approve the 2016 Comprehensive Plan Proposed Amendment Docket List, or PAL, based on the recommendations of Planning Commission at their May 12, 2016 meeting.
Second.
Thank you. Any more comments or questions? Councilmember Sessions.
Thank you. Again, we didn't need to have it repeated. You all did such a good job in explaining all those to us. And while I'm going to vote in favor to move it, the docket forward, thank you for explaining that again as well. I still have questions regarding one of the 11. I would like to learn more still about the Kid City proposal. Not necessarily tonight, but as you go through the process, I know you're probably going to be giving us more information, so I'll be interested in that.
We will do that. We did also get a more clarified request from the property owner. I believe you were given copies of that by their attorney. We've already begun, or will shortly begin, the conversation with the city attorney as to whether or not any of those meet legal muster. But yes, we will resolve it.
Thank you.
Anything else? Yeah, Councilmember Cotton.
Thank you. And I would just encourage anyone out there that's curious about anything. We did discuss this at great length at the work session. We went through, I think, each line item, each map item, and talked about all kinds of setbacks and proximity to single family. So that discussion is all in there, and so I'll be supporting this because I feel comfortable that staff has done their diligence on this.
Council President.
Director Krause, I ask this as somebody who's had to wade through these weeds himself. Is the owner of the Kid City property, is that in any way eligible for a concomitant zoning agreement?
Council President, that is the issue that we're trying to work through with the city attorney. The initial concern that staff has is the only way to do that is to change the comprehensive plan map to show commercial use there. And then the question is whether or not some sort of concomitant zoning or contractual basis can box that in very narrowly so that's the only thing that's permissible there. We don't know the answers to that yet.
Okay. I just wanted to ask the question because, as I said, it was on my mind. Thanks.
All right. Anything else, Council? All right. All those in favor of approving the 2016 Comprehensive Plan Proposed Amendment Docket List, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposition? Thank you. We'll move on to 90.3C. This is an ordinance repealing Chapter 2.25 LMC, dissolving the Linwood Library Board. Councilmember Sessions,
yes,
might
you
do that?
Oh, sure. Let's see. All right. I move to adopt the ordinance repealing Chapter 2.2.
Ordinance number
3194. 3194. Okay. I move the ordinance number 3194, an ordinance of the City Council of City of Linwood, Washington, repealing Chapter 2.25. LMC dissolving the Linwood Library Board, providing for severability, establishing an effective date, and providing for summary publication.
Second.
Thank you. Do you want to speak to that ordinance?
Yeah. I was the Library Board liaison from the council briefly since January. And for those of you who haven't heard about this, it might feel a little shocking and kind of icky that what was going on with the library board? Why? Actually, years ago when the ownership of the library, is that the best way to put it? The ownership of the library?
Yes.
Yeah, it changed. And because the library board used to make decisions and get back to the Linwood City Council. But because of the way that the library board, or the library is now administered, it's not needed. And so for years, the library board wasn't actually doing any city business. And so it just lost its job, kind of, but it kept going. And while it was, you know, cool for a few people who were on it, and the librarian there did a wonderful job in making presentations and keeping us up to date and letting us know what was going on, there was nothing that we could do to take action. And so talking to the different library board members, they completely understand and agree. And they're working with our Julie Moore to help us out and volunteer in other ways that they like in the city as well. And so we decided that that was the best thing to do. I should also mention this has nothing to do with the Friends of the Library. That is still completely intact and needed, and please support them with your books and donations.
Thank you. Any other comments? All right, we have a roll call vote, please. Mm-hmm.
Councilmember Ross?
Yes.
Councilmember Sessions?
Yes.
Councilmember Sutton?
Yes.
Council President Boyer?
Aye.
Councilmember Cotton?
Yes.
Council Vice President Goodwin?
Aye.
Councilmember Hurst?
Yes.
7 yes.
Thank you. Ordinance number 3194 passes unanimously. All right, moving on. We do not have an executive session this evening, so we'll move into new business. And I believe Council Member Cotton has a couple of new business items to present.
I do. Thank you, Your Honor. And this is the portion of the evening where I warned I would take up some oxygen. So, So the first item is on the yellow sheet, and thank you, Executive Council Assistant Morris, for getting these printed and prepared. Mm-hmm. On the yellow sheets in front of you is item 100, new business motion, so I'll read it. I move that the City Council reconfirm and reappoint Commissioner Pinning Reyes to position number 2 of the Neighborhoods and Demographic Diversity Commission for a 3-year term set to expire December 31st, 2018.
I second.
Council President?
Point of order. Your Honor, I would suggest that this item is contrary to previously passed ordinances and regulations of the City of Linwood regarding the process for appointing. appointing commissioners and approving commissioners, and I would ask parliamentarian and city attorney for a ruling.
Well, I can give you my thoughts on whether the council has authority to appoint an advisory body member in the absence of a nomination. And I did look, because I did look at that question briefly today, and I came to the conclusion that under, if you read the entirety of LMC 2.24.030 as a whole, it's my opinion that the process to appoint someone to a vacant position, even if it's somebody who was a previous commissioner, should follow the same process as for an initial appointment. And that's reading the whole section together, and also that would be consistent with RCW 35A12090 that gives the mayor the power to appoint city officials, and the council only has the power to confirm appointments if they've provided for that by ordinance.
Councilmember Cotton?
May I ask for some clarifications? Mm-hmm. So the RCW that you quoted, is it a limiting that we can't add to it that a city council also has the authority, or does it, like,
In the case of this RCW, I believe it's limiting. It defines the powers between the two body, the two entities of the in your local government.
So even if I read the LMC in a certain way, the RCW takes precedence as it is Washington state law, and we couldn't essentially write an LMC that would override Washington law.
Probably not. I'm not going to give a clear black and white answer on that, but.
I appreciate that clarification.
But that RCW did kind of help inform my interpretation of your city code provision.
Okay. And then just the last follow-on question, and that would be then under LMC 2.24.030.G, where it talks about 90 days prior to term expiration, the way I was reading it, unaware of the RCW, when considering renomination or reappointment, the mayor and the city council may consider factors. The way I read that, the and was to be that the mayor and the city council had equal power in that renomination or reappointment. But what you're saying is based on the RCW, that is not possible.
Well, I'm saying the RCW helped me in trying to figure out what the council's intent would have been in passing that section and in reading all of the provisions together. It just seemed like the intent was that the same nomination and confirmation process was to be followed. And that was consistent with my understanding of how the city has always done it.
Based on our parliamentarian and city lawyer's expertise in this matter, I would just like to withdraw this motion then, since I don't want to put a motion forward that would be at risk of breaking RCW.
Okay.
All right.
Do we need to vote on that?
Well, the second would need to agree.
Oh. Who's this? Oh, Shirley was the
second.
Shirley
was the second.
Because the motion at this point is the motion of the bodies.
Oh. Yeah.
I do agree to withdraw.
Okay. So then do we all need to vote to withdraw? Or is that just...
I guess,
semantics at this point.
Yeah.
All those in favor of withdrawing the motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposition?
No.
Thank you. All right. So, Councilmember Cotton, you have another
one? Yes. The second item is on the beige/peach/tan sheet, depending on your color register of this lighting. And it's khaki. Okay, very good. We had a resolution earlier, which was 2016-08, so I assume the next resolution number is 2016-09?
Yes.
Okay, very good. So I move that the City Council of the City of Linwood adopt resolution number 2016-09, a resolution of the City of Linwood to adopt a regular schedule of meetings for the Neighborhoods and Demographics Diversity Commission for the remainder of 2016. Don't need to read the whole thing, or...
No.
Okay. So we've got the body of it before us. So the motion has been moved. Do I have a second?
Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you. Would you like to speak to your motion?
Yes, I would. I know that there's been a lot of discussion recently about the future of the Diversity Commission. In writing this, what kind of spurred the writing of this was last work session when Councilmember Hurst brought up the issue of potential violations of Open Meetings Act, where if two of them converse, they could be in violation in discussion of city business. And then I thought that, well, a commission of three, we know that they've had issues, but it seems to me that in order to get this commission to be on a path of reconciliation and to repair it and restore it, they need to be able to be meeting officially, so that as a quorum of three, two of them can talk about city business and discuss the commission and come to a reconciliation. The heart of this is that I really believe that we need all of our commissions operational and functioning. I know that this particular commission has had a recent rocky history, but I guess I disagree with the philosophy that putting it on a shelf or letting it sit for too long is the best method. I really think that if you get people sitting around a table and talking, that they're going to come to consensus, and that the better part of their human nature will come forward, and that reconciliation, forgiveness, and ultimately the work of the city can then progress in the commission. So that's what's at the heart of this resolution, is restoring this commission to operation so that it can really truly get back on a healthy track and get moving forward. And that's why I bring it before you.
Council President.
Thank you, Your Honor. First of all, I want to say that my colleagues' sense of desiring reconciliation for that body does him great credit. And I understand that, and I wholeheartedly agree with it. However, it's also been my experience over many years as a pastor and someone who people come to work on reconciliation, that you can't force the beginnings of that process. It has to evolve. And sometimes the best thing for folks who are in conflict to do is to take a little break, think about what's going on, get ready to come back together and talk. And I think the commission has expressed its desire to take that break. We've already had a ruling from city attorney that the commission does indeed have the authority to cancel meetings as long as it's not in perpetuity. They can't dissolve themselves as a body, but they can cancel a number of meetings. At this point, I think we've missed one meeting of that body. Is that right? And I would suggest that it's probably not time yet to force those folks together. So although I truly do agree with the spirit that Councilmember Cotton has suggested in this, I can't agree with the details, and I would suggest instead that Councilmember Cotton and perhaps myself meet with the mayor to continue to talk about how this is going to evolve. Perhaps Councilmember Hurst would like to be a part of that conversation, so that we can work out a system and a structure for this reconciliation and restart, and take our time and be thoughtful and really get it so that it's right, so that we can bring these folks together again to work instead of to fight. So that's my thought, and I will not be supporting the resolution.
Councilmember Sutton.
Thank you very much, Mayor. How much more talking is this going to take? You know, we are in I understand, Council President, you are the liaison to this commission, so I'm not usurping your authority. But what I want clear is exactly what is the timeline. We talk about talking, getting we haven't said that we were bringing the people that are involved together for you to be meeting with them at all. They're left out of this picture. So how can you have an agreement if they're not part of the solution?
Thank you. Councilmember Ross?
Yes, thank you. While I also agree with the intent of this, I can't support the specifics of it. This commission made this decision. We have to respect that. We have to respect the fact that they came together and said, this is not working. We need some time away. And to be disrespectful of that decision is not someplace I'm willing to go. So I don't know that the conversations that need to happen have happened. I hope that they will in the very near future, and maybe the council can be the lead on that conversation. But to say to a commission, you legally voted for something and we're not going to do it because we don't like it, you know, because we expect something different. This tool does not provide what you're asking for, Shirley. It says you will meet whether you like it or not. Even though you voted not to, you're still going to have to. And I don't think that's the message we want to send to this commission. I think we want to let them come to the table prepared to work out their differences. Thank you.
Councilmember Sutton.
I haven't heard where they have been asked to come to the table, Commissioner Ross. What I am saying is that if they can't be part of the discussion, they cannot do the solution. So all I'm asking is that they be involved in their fate. That's what I'm asking. Thank you.
Councilmember Goodwin.
Thank you. In our duties as council members, we have a number of things that we oversee, that we do, that we vote on. One of those things is helping the boards and commissions. Really, we have appointments, we're liaisons to them to help and really report back from them to the council. You know, this is what's happening, this is what I think we can do to help. But I really don't think it's our responsibility to force the issue on them. Again, as has been mentioned, the commission themselves, they voted to hold off on the meetings. The decision by our city attorney said that was legal, again, as Council President Boyer said, as long as it's not in perpetuity where it's just continuing on and on, but there's a reason for it. They need some time, and I think the mayor has already expressed her intent and her plans to go forward with a mediator to help that commission to come together, as Councilmember Sutton said, to come together and discuss what are the issues, what can we do to resolve these issues, because this is a much needed commission and board in our community. And I think we all realize that, and we all want what's best for that commission, what's best for the community. And I think at this time, letting them have that time away is the best thing for them, because that's what they've asked for. And so I will not be supporting this particular motion tonight either.
Councilmember Hurst.
I think part of this issue, well, there's a couple of parts of this issue. The first is that the Diversity Commission voted to suspend meetings, but they voted to suspend them based on the fact that the council would be coming back with recommendations, of which we haven't done anything on that. And really, when you look at it, we're talking about the city council is the policymaker for the city. The mayor is the administrator. We are the ones that should be setting the policy for these commissions. And in fact, according to the advisory body ordinance, we're the ones that are supposed to be reviewing all the boards and commissions. And we are supposed to be reviewing these at least every 4 years. And as far as my knowledge, the city council has not reviewed any of these boards and commissions. And so if there is going to be a review, it should be made up of council members. And I do believe that because of the actions of the mayor, we've been forced to have this commission with 3 members. And that is just ridiculous. There was a commissioner who wanted to be reappointed. That name has never been brought forward. I would like to see in writing from our attorney all the basis of her arguments, because I see in our ordinance, reappointment is different than appointment. And it's a whole different procedure. But going back to this resolution, I do believe we need input from our boards and commissions on budget. And yes, we're going to have a joint meeting this week. But it's not going to be with the Diversity Commission as a commission. It's going to, if they show up, it'll be as individual members. I think it's time that this Diversity Commission gets back together. I think it's time we move forward and start appointing people who have applied for this commission, people that actually did not appear on the list that we were given a couple weeks ago as far as people who have applied for boards and commissions. There were names on there that, or there are not names on there, of people who have been interviewed. So I don't understand the administration's stance of blocking people being able to join this Diversity Commission. Thank you.
Councilmember, the list that you got, it only included people for the yearly report that applied through April. And the commissioners that I've interviewed were after April. That's why they weren't on the list. Councilmember Sessions?
Thank you. And just, Ian, thank you for your heart on this, and I appreciate your spirit of this. And your positivity, I really appreciate that. And also, I appreciate you giving us heads up about this and not surprising us on the dais. I respect that as well. One thing that was mentioned was that we need our boards and commissions to give us input on the budget for outcomes, and that is really important and critical, and we're looking forward to that. With that said, it's also very critical that we get input for budget for outcomes from our citizens, from individuals. And so by no means are those three people who are currently on the Diversity Commission, are they, I mean, we'd love that to hear from them. We'd love to hear what they have to say when it comes to budget for outcomes. So this doesn't stop that at all. I would also still like to have a summit, including a variety of different diverse communities, to see what they would like to do in moving forward with the Diversity Commission. I still would like to see that happen, and we haven't had any talks about that. Also, I would also like to hear a timeline. While I wouldn't be approving of this resolution tonight, I would like to see a timeline so that we can kind of get on with this. I think we've spent a lot of time on this, and we need to make a decision. And we have a lot of different stakes, and this one, you know, we need to move on and decide one way or another what's happening and get it finished. Thank you.
Councilmember Cotton.
Thank you, Your Honor. And I just want to say I appreciate all my fellow council members up here and the civility to which we're just discussing this issue, because I know it is, you know, we're all trying to drive towards what we believe to be the proper and right solution. We just sometimes are not going to agree, and that's okay. I just want to address just a couple comments, if I will. I really appreciate Councilmember Sutton's points about that the commissioners need to be brought together to resolve their differences. Sometimes leadership as the policymaking body of this legislative branch of the city of Linwood requires us to lead, and sometimes that means asking through policy and directive to get people to sit down when they're not willing to sit down. Part of effective conflict resolution is getting people to tear the Band-Aid off and sit down and start discussing again. The other thing we have is we have a commission of only three. When they vote to suspend meetings based until council can reevaluate, you have two commissioners that are for and one and against. So you have a very without additional commissioners, there's a reason why it's a body of seven. Without additional commissioners, without that commission fully staffed, it's very easy for people with opposing views, and keep in mind this is our diversity commission, of course, it's going to be the place where the most diverse and opposing viewpoints are going to exist. It's natural for this commission probably to be a place where there is more discourse and less dialogue, and especially if you have fewer people to help balance out that discussion and bring a calmer voice to discussions that might otherwise rise out of control, and where things are said and people can't get past it, and then they go on a hiatus, and now we have a commission that's no longer functioning currently. And then lastly, I would just say that the LMC states that we're the city council that determines what some of these advisory bodies are to do by motion, resolution, and ordinance. And so I saw a resolution as an excellent mechanism to get us to where I think we need to go. And especially because as part of the Diversity Commission's strategic plan, one of their key elements was to be trusted messengers to their communities. And if we want to bring all the voices, especially to the table surrounding the budget, one of the LMCs, which governs the scopes of work for them, is to review relevant portions of the city budget and suggest desired amendments. And when you have a diversity commission with which is staffed with people which are the trusted messengers to unrepresented or underrepresented populations in our city, I see it as critical to get them at the table and to give us input. So that's why I'm moving this forward. That's why I'll be supporting it tonight. And I appreciate all of your opinions on this, and I know we're not always going to agree on everything, and I respect you all, regardless of where we sit on this tonight. So,
anything else?
I call for a roll call vote, please.
You want a roll call for it?
Yep.
Okay. Councilmember Sutton?
Yes.
Council President Boyer?
No.
Councilmember Cotton?
Yes.
Council Vice President Goodwin?
No.
Councilmember Hurst?
Yes.
Councilmember Ross?
No.
Councilmember Sessions?
No.
Three no, four yes.
No, yeah,
I'm sorry. No, sorry. Three yes, four no, three yes.
A win by technicality.
Sorry about that. Thank you. Resolution 2016-09 does not pass. All right, any other new business?
No.
And I would entertain adjournment motion.
Second.
All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposition? Have a good evening. Thanks, everyone, for being here.
Thank you.